جنات أندروبيا.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
In this exercise, we are going to determine the velocity vector of a cannonball. Determine the expression of the position vector of the cannonball. Determine the equation of the trajectory of the ball. Calculate the maximum height reached by the ball. Calculate the time of a flight of the ball. And calculate the range of the ball.
A cannonball is fired from the origin O with an initial velocity which makes an angle alpha with the horizontal. The magnitude of the initial velocity is 40 meters per second, and the origin O is 6 meters above the ground. Given that sine alpha equals 0.8 and cosine alpha equals 0.6, use G equals 10 meters per second squared. Number 1. Determine the initial position vector and the initial velocity vector of the ball in the xy plane. So at time 0, since the ball starts from the origin O, then x of 0 and y of 0 equals 0. Therefore, r of 0 equals 0. Now, let's determine the initial velocity of the ball. Look at the figure. V0 has two components. One along the x-axis V0x and one along the y-axis V0y. So V0 equals V0x plus V0y. In the right-angled triangle, V0x is adjacent to alpha. So V0x equals cosine alpha times V0. V0y is adjacent, is opposite to alpha. Then V0y equals V0 sine alpha. Now replace V0 by 40, cosine alpha by 0.6, and sine alpha by 0.8. Therefore, V0 equals 24i plus 32j in SI units.
Let's move to part 2. Determine the expression of the velocity vector of the ball. Our system is the cannonball. Let's use Newton's second law to determine its acceleration. The only force acting on the ball is its weight, mg. Then, mg equals ma. Therefore, a equals g. Now, look at the y-axis. It is oriented positively upwards, but the gravitational acceleration is vertically downwards. Then, a equals minus 10g, and it is expressed in meters per second squared in SI units. Now, we want to determine the expression of the velocity. The velocity is the integral or the antiderivative of the acceleration with respect to time. Let me remind you with this rule of the antiderivative. If y is the antiderivative of b with respect to time, where b is constant, then y equals bt plus y0. Now, look at this equation. V is similar to y, and a is similar to b. Then, v equals minus 10tj plus v0. What is v0? v0 is the initial velocity of the ball. Replace v0 by its expression. You will get this equation. Rearrange. Then, the velocity of the ball is 24i plus minus 10t plus 32 into j in SI units.
Number 4. Determine the expression of the position vector and then write the parametric equations. The position vector is given by the antiderivative of the velocity vector with respect to time. Given that if y equals the antiderivative of bt dt, where b is a constant, then y equals bt squared over 2 plus y of 0. Now, let's make the antiderivative of the velocity vector with respect to time. 24 is a constant, so the antiderivative of 24 with respect to time is 24t. Minus 10t is similar to bt. Therefore, the antiderivative of minus 10t with respect to time is minus 10t squared over 2. Similarly, the antiderivative of 32 is 32t. We get this expression of r. Rearrange, we get this new expression. But r equals xi plus yj. So x equals 24t and y equals minus 5t squared plus 32t. These are the parametric equations.
Let's move to part 5, determine the equation of the trajectory. In order to determine the equation of the trajectory, we eliminate t between x and y. X equals 24t, then t equals x over 24. Replace t in the expression of y by x over 24. You will get this equation. Rearrange. So this is the trajectory equation of the ball.
Focus, please. This is important.
Number 6. Determine the maximum height reached by the cannonball relative to the ground. To determine the maximum height, we have to determine the time needed by the ball to reach the highest position at A. At the highest position, the velocity has no component along the y-axis, or Vy equals 0, but V equals 24i plus minus 10t plus 32j, so Vy equals minus 10t plus 32. At A, Vy equals 0, so minus 10t plus 32 equals 0. Then the time needed by the ball to reach A is 3.2 seconds. Now, to determine the maximum height of the ball relative to the x-axis, replace t by 3.2, then y maximum equals 51 meter. To determine the maximum height relative to the ground, we have to add h or 6 meters to y maximum. Then h maximum equals y maximum plus h, which is equal to 57 meters.
Let's move to part 7. Determine the time of a flight of the ball and the horizontal distance dc traveled on the ground. Let's start with the time of a flight. Look at point C. It is the end of the journey. Now, what is the ordinate of point C? The ordinate of point C is minus 6 meters because point C is below the origin of the y-axis, which is oriented positively upwards. Now, replace y by minus 6 in the expression of y. You will get this equation. Rearrange. Now, using the calculator gives this answer. Therefore, the time of a flight is 6.58 seconds. Now, let's calculate the distance DC. Again, look at point C. The abscessa at point C is the distance DC. Then, in order to calculate DC, let's calculate the abscessa at this instant. Then, DC equals the abscessa at time 6.58 seconds. Replace t in the expression of x by 6.58 seconds. Therefore, DC equals 158 meters.
Here we have another method to determine the distance DC using the equation of the trajectory proved before. At the point C, y equals minus 6 meters. So replace y by minus 6, we get this equation. Rearrange, we get another equation. Using the calculator, it gives two values of x. The first value equals minus 4.38 meters, but the abscessa of C is positive, so this solution is rejected to be the abscessa of x. The other solution, x equals 158 meters, so DC, which is equal to the abscessa of C, equals 158 meters.
Let's move to part 8, determine the distance OB or the range. Look at the figure. What is the abscessa of point B? Its abscessa is OB or the range. What is the ordinate of point B? It is 0. Now, replace Y in the equation of the trajectory by 0. You will get this equation. Take X as a common factor in this equation. You will get this equation. This equation has two solutions. Let's start with the first solution. X equals 0. This solution is not acceptable because X equals 0 is the launch position. And we want to calculate the distance OB. Now, let's move to the second solution. 0 equals minus 5 times x over 576 plus 4 over 3. Then, x equals 154 meters. This solution is acceptable. Therefore, the range is 154 meters.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.